we don't do that. We don't do that. Yeah, well, people don't take me seriously because of my size. You know what I'm saying? They don't take me seriously because I'm a big guy. So believe it or not, back in the days, I used to be a fashion designer. Yeah. You know, remember Carl Canal? That was a black fashion designer. I was down with him. Cross Colors. Anybody know Cross Colors? Woo! Yeah. There you go. Nostalgia Brother. Yeah, so I used to work with them and help them out, you know, make designs and everything. I said, okay, well, since, you know, they're famous now, why don't I make my own brand? You know what I'm saying? So I came up with the brilliant idea of something called Black Biscuit. Yeah, you know that. It failed miserably. The logo was a black burnt charred biscuit being thrown across the room. All right? So that didn't go well. I was just at work the other day laughing at the idea all day long. My own creation. But when I used to go to fashion shows, and Fashion Week, they used to have the industry parties. Right? So I'll stay with the rest of the fashion designers. And a guest or a fan or whoever, a buyer would come up, and they see what was standing there. They say, who brought the bodyguard? No bodyguard, I'm a fashion designer, Black Biscuit. They say, never heard of it. So I say, okay, let me get from the crowd, you know, let me stand over here by the door and just chill, watch everybody drinking, watch everybody, you know, mingle. So people start walking up to me, come from the door, handing me their IDs. Why are you handing me your ID? Aren't you a bouncer? No, I'm a fashion designer, Black Biscuit. They said to me, never heard of it. I just had a runway full of people wearing my stuff. What do you mean you never heard of it? I can't go nowhere. Especially not on 42nd Street. Because I didn't know that German tourists still love the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. They love it. And they think I'm Uncle Phil. And they want to take pictures of me like I'm Elmo. And millennials are the worst. I'm sure we got a few in the audience here. And they say, wow, I grew up with you. I don't know you. What do you mean you grew up with me? I watched you on the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. You're Uncle Phil, right? I say, does it look like I will be Uncle Phil standing here on 42nd Street? Does it look like I know Will Smith? Would I be standing on 42nd Street if I knew Will Smith? I don't get your millennials, okay? I don't get your terminologies either. For a long time, I thought M-I was L-F, was milk spelled wrong. I thought memes was Mimi. I thought they were talking about Mariah Carey or something. I thought emojis and lines over there, I thought that was Jumanji 2 or something. And hashtags, forget it, I just thought it was just hash browns. We ain't far from the village. I can't stay in the village either because of my size. That's right. Yeah. Because the gay gentleman there think I'm a big bear. A bear. Yes, I am. A big bear, you know what I'm saying? So they walk up to me and say, are you a gay bear? I say, no, I'm not no gay bear. You know what I'm saying? Is Suge not a gay? He says, no. I says, Uncle Phil gay? He says, no. So why do you think I'm gay? He says, well, you're big, you're black, and you're in the village. Good answer. And then women are biased towards big guys too, believe it or not. Because y'all think we sweat too much when we're on top of you. Right, right, and the sweat falls into the eyes and stings. You know what I'm saying? Come on, y'all had it? You women had it? A man sweat in your eyes, and it stings, it's uncomfortable, it breaks the mood, it breaks everything. Everything stops, and then the guy is apologizing all the time. So the erection might go down. So everything is spoiled, so but in the hood, they have a solution They make us wear sweat shields. Now, have you ever had your dog neutered? And you know the dogs wear the big collars or them, one of the cones, whatever it is? Yes, they have that for big people, so we don't, you know, we don't sweat on the woman while we're doing our thing while we're on top. Yes, it is real. Yes, it's true. I sound like Kurt Angle. It's true. Yes, it's true. All right? And airports are biased towards big people, if you didn't realize that. All right? Everybody just wants to pull over the attention. All right? Yes, because they tape measure us to see how many seats we're going to take up. Yes, they tape measure us, actually. Wow. It's true. I told you her name. All right? So they tape measure me, and they said, sir, you're going to have to pay for two seats. I said, outrageous. That's unfounded. They said, why are you upset? Because when I get on the 4 train, I take up 3 seats. So you're wrong. And now I'm getting over y'all because I'm just paying for 2 seats and you can't take it back. Fast food restaurants are biased towards big people. I got a whole list. I'm like the Black Jets, Jeff Foxworthy. You know what I'm saying? Yes, they're biased towards, especially Burger King. All right, man? Burger King, because they have a deal where you get 2 Whoppers, 2 fries, and 2 sodas for the price of 1. But the kicker is you only get 1 cookie. What is 2 fat people gonna do with 1 cookie? I fought my girlfriend over that cookie. That's a relationship breaker right there. And McDonald's, forget about it, they're just trying to kill us. They got degrees of freaking Big Macs now. Degrees of Big Macs. The Junior Big Mac, the Regular Big Mac, the Southwest Big Mac, and now the Grand Big Mac. How do you get any grander than a Big Mac? But now they moved the Grand Big Mac when you serve, you don't know. All right, because you didn't think I was Uncle Phil in the first place. Look at that. No, I'm season 1 Uncle Phil. They would refer to season 7 Uncle Phil. Okay, now you get it. But the Grand Big Mac is 2 of what, the quarter pounder patties on there. They might as well just say, sir, would you like fries, or would you like supersize, or can we give you a gun with that? It'll blow your brains out. And Whole Foods, everybody, Whole Foods is biased towards big people as well. Because now that you know that Whole Foods has a unisex bathroom now, where women and men can go in the bathroom. They're trying to be real texty, you know what I'm saying? So, gentlemen like you walked in, the women, everybody in, problems. I go in and they're screaming. Yeah, they're screaming. I said, Miss, why are you screaming? She said, you're too big and scared to be in the bathroom. Well, I said, your hair is too stupid. It looks like a mop and weaves to be in here. I'm going to take it off and mop the floor. You white women ain't got to worry about weaves, so that's your problem. You're not going to wear one over your heads. Y'all got such pretty hair over here. Yeah, I had a crush on pink. You remind me of pink. The closest thing to white chocolate y'all have in the industry right now. I'm going on script right now because I got a thing for pink. But I like a woman that can beat up a man. Alright, and the city bikes are biased too. I'm envious of all you people in here with these city bikes. Y'all can get on them and ride, you can swipe a card and ride and have a good old time, don't y'all? But not people that's over 300 pounds. Because they got something on the city bikes called anti-fat bricks. That's right. I swipe, got on the car, the bike, sat on it, and it would not move. I get on it, move. I sat on it, it won't move. Look at that crap. I'm out of here. Wait a minute. I got to put it back. My card is on that. All right, and last but least before I get out of here, my friends were biased towards me too because they wanted to take me on a seafood run. Yeah, a seafood run. To Red Lobster. I said, great, seafood. You know, Red Lobster, you know, seafood run. I think, you know, let's go on a run and get some seafood. Unbeknownst known to me was that what they make in the hood by seafood run is that they eat, they get up, and they run. I'll Red Lobster, and since I'm the fattest, I can't run. I'm stuck with the bill. But jokes on them, because in 120 Fish Street, Red Lobster, they have a chase team that's dressed just like the all black, with gym shoes. So if you try to outrun them, they got four of them running right behind you to get you to pay for your Red Lobster meal. So if any of y'all thinking about running and Red Lobster, don't call me. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
But like me included, like if I came home from fourth grade and my like 10-piece chicken McNugget wasn't on the table, somebody was like gonna die. Like one time we ran out of whole milk and I tried to sacrifice myself. I just like laid on the bed. I'm like, take me now, God, please. Like I was like destined for this. Like my first birthday party was at McDonald's. Like the celebration of my birth was hosted by the Hamburglar. That's how much my parents valued my life. Okay. All right. We now have a fabulous sketch group coming up for you.